was just wondering how many times you fucked my boyfriend.
Absolute pet!
I'm Josh, by the way. Abigail's brother.
Sweet.
So I messed around with Maxie a bit. So what? She's gonna feel so good when she gets me back.
You sure?
Of course she will. Sid?
Cut the drinks. Spit in my face.
You might be just the right person to help with my photographic project.
It's study of the human form.
Josh! He sent me pictures of Abigail.
That's pretty screwy. They can be the shots of your own sister.
I think I might love you.
It's an awfully long sentence, Tony.
Blessed are those who can give without remembering, and take without forgetting. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks, Effy. But you know, this is the best birthday present I could have. Nice family meal. Chance to have a bit of quality time.
Oh, isn't that lovely?
You know, this reminds me of when I was a boy and my Auntie Mabel, when she was carving the chicken, she always used to wear these really loose-fitting tops and...
Yeah, yes, I think we've all heard this one, haven't we?
It's a joke, Anthea, an anecdote. And my dad, your grandfather, God rest his soul, what would you like, David? She used to say, and he'd look right down her front and say, I'd like breast, please, Mabel, and then maybe a bit of leg and stuffing. Yeah. I mean, he'd basically growl at her. See, that's a difficult dad.
No one thinks you're difficult, Jim.
And then Mabel would get to me. Oh, what could I ask for? Scoured my brain and came up with, thigh, please, Mabel. I basically asked for the only thing I could think of that was non-sexual. Thigh.
Well, thighs can be sexy.
That's not true.
You'd be surprised you can do a lot with thighs, Dad.
No, you can't. Look, I'm sorry, what is so sexy about thighs? I mean, what on earth can you do with a thigh?
He's not in front of Effy, Jim.
Right. What would everyone like?
Like a bit of thigh, please, Dad.
No, not yet. Did I say do it yet?
No, look, Jim, Effie's rolled a 5.
Oh, yes, well, right, well, jolly good. All right, then, we'll treat that as your go, then, Effie. So you've got a 5. Oh, God, I can't understand these rules. They translated them from Korean.
Jim, maybe we shouldn't play a game.
Fine. Fucking fine. Fucking fine. So, what should we do then? Just sit, shall we?
Yeah, we could just sit, yeah?
Okay.
And I'll see if I can find some nice biscuits. Okay.
Oh, I hate it when your mother's like this.
Sweetheart.
There's no Look at there, Anna. What's wrong? Edgar.
What's everyone doing tonight?
Well, there's a few people come around to mine, but it's a homework thing, really.
Is Michelle coming?
Yeah. Yeah, but it's for a class that you're not in. It's biology. You're not in it.
It's fine, Chris. I'm not invited, right?
I don't think you'd enjoy it, really.
Yeah, I know.
I'm asleep, or just
too poor
to speak to you, so leave a
message. Is this now officially silent treatment you're giving me? Michelle broke up with me, remember? Still, if you think this is going to piss me off, then you're wrong. I actually quite like it. I'm just going to keep on filling up your voicemail with all sorts of shit.
I'm never neurotic.
Dad's always check up on their baby girls, it's what we do.
Nick. She's asleep. Come on, let's go to bed.
Bed, but it's early. Panorama.
I don't think that I've given you my birthday present yet.
Auntie Mabel.
Mm-hmm.
She was a name and not a real blood relative.
I know exactly what she was. I'll fetch the turkey baster and you wash your bits.
Said that was well rough because women used to wear fishnets without knickers. At orgies or whatever. It's like my mum would have got stuff on it. Davey calls it lady juice. Can you believe he called it lady juice? And he says by wearing the tights that her stuff would have rubbed off on me. Then why wore knickers? And I don't think my mum went to many orgies. I mean, she grew up in Luton. I don't think many orgies happen in Luton. I keep tasting sick in my mouth. I think it's because I'm excited and nervous. Do you ever get that? Tasting sick in your mouth like you got the hiccups, but you haven't. Do you ever get that, Effy? Do you? Did I tell you about Davey trying to finger me?
Effy, he came. I mean, cool. I mean, I wasn't sure you would. Hi.
My last day, and the fucking wankers to work for. So you know, break, take, steal, anarchy and all that. Mad.
So this is it? Really?
Mm-hmm. is making me ill. You got no friends in your home.
This is Spencer, a mate of mine.
Hi, I'm Julie, and this is Effy. Do people call you Spence?
No, they don't. I've heard a lot about you, Effy. Not all of it good.
You heard anything about me?
Want a ride?
Shall I get on too?
Issue.
A bit late for you, isn't it, Kenny?
Last week's edition. Drinks are usually too generous, aren't they? We won't be there.
On my own tonight. Listen, you don't fancy a beer, do you?
Sorry, beer's not really my drink. Now, once you taste the Pinot Grigio, hops just lose their allure.
Right, okay. Do you want a hand? Sell him.
Where's all your mates then, Tone? Fallen on hard times, have you, Shark?
Something like that.
Well, no offence, pal, but the sooner I get these sold, the sooner I can get on to the missus for cocoa and kettles. I'm not going to get much soul standing next to a posh lad, am I? Balloon bed.
Right, OK. No worries. See you later.
Fella. The gishu, fella?
Enjoy yourself.
Branch Police Station, Roger Watt speaking. How may I help you?
Sorry,
I rushed it. I'll go again. Clifton Branch Police Station, Marjorie Watts. How can I help you?
Hi, Marjorie. I'm here to pick up Elizabeth Stoneham. She's been arrested.
Okie dokie. I'll check that for you. Just missed her. Her brother's picked her up already.
I'm her brother.
A rather brother.
I'm her only brother.
Okay, her boyfriend pretending to be her brother's picked her up already. She just left with a fat lad.
Ladies, your carriage waits. Come on, chop, chop.
Effy!
The agent.
Well, that was fun. Unexpected, but fun.
So fucking hard to keep a straight face.
I did well for a fat fuck.
You're so lucky, Effy. I can't believe it. Remember when I tried to get arrested for kissing that police officer? Remember that? Normally I would have been with her. We were always getting into trouble together at school. Tell him, Effy, aren't
we? Ever stop?
Tell him.
Anyone want some?
What is it? We're known as the Cheeky Girls. Not that we're Romania, you know. Show off her pants!
Hi, this is Effie's phone. She's currently cruising at 35,000 feet, and there's definitely turbulence ahead.
What? It's, Tony. Effie, what's going on?
Hello?
Look, wait, can we get some concentration here, please, for a minute? I know it seems hard, right, but think about it. This could lead to, you know, celebrity.
Placing a Guinness Book of Records is hardly celebrity.
It is. Right, I fucking love that book. Michelle, will you stop eating the tools, please?
Look, it's not my fault you decided to go for sugar cube pyramids.
Oh, hi. What's this? Some kind of retro LSD thing?
Oh, no, this, it's kind of that homework thing I was telling you about, the, biology.
Hi, Michelle.
Hello, Tony.
Look, don't worry, I'm not going to stay. Just need to sit for a minute.
I'm busy.
Yeah, I can see that, Sid. Go on. Let's have a go, then.
Oh. Oh. Fucking hell, guys. You don't have a good time, do you?
Look, I don't want this to be difficult, Tony. If you want to stay, you can stay.
No, it's fine. You made the divorce terms perfectly clear, and I intend to stick to them.
Please don't be a bastard.
Look, don't get upset about it, OK? I'm sorry I spoiled your beautiful evening. I'll go. Sid?
Well, go on, then. Go see what he wants.
Don't feel you have to, Sid.
I'm gonna go. But I need to tell him to leave, right? You should leave, Tony. No one wants you here.
Shit!
You okay? I tried ringing, but you haven't answered your phone all week.
What, did you get beaten up?
Effie's missing. We need to look for her.
Effy, is this another one of your games?
Yes, Sid. It's a game.
Hi, this is Effy's phone. She's currently cruising at 35,000 feet. There's definitely turbulence ahead.
Sounds a bit weird, Tony.
It's fine. We'll nick your dad's car, drive around a bit, spot her, take her home, and then go for a pint.
Oh, shit!
What?
It's Cassie.
Oh, she was there.
So where's she gone? Flying off on her broomstick. It's just her imagination, Sid. She's still in the loony bin.
No, she was there.
Maybe she's haunting you because she tried to kill herself because of you. Come on, Sid.
Hang on. You want to nick my dad's car?
Why can't we nick your dad's instead? Because, Sid, my dad has central locking, a sophisticated alarm system, and probably thinks a spell in prison will do me good. Whereas your dad has a 20-year-old car, neighbourhood watch, I won't prosecute.
I know who you're thinking about.
There's times I think me and Tony are going to get back together.
And just like that, I'm 10 quid richer.
There's a sort of thing, though, isn't there? First loves.
You think Tony loved you?
No, I don't.
Sorry. That sounded far less harsh in my head.
Don't worry about it.
I'm Michelle.
Well, listen. I'm off to a late night at the sports club. Fancy you coming? Quick drink?
Can you not take a hint?
Come on. Must have worked out by now that I didn't do it.
You had porno pictures of your sister on your phone. How fucked up are you?
Someone set me up.
Yeah, right, Josh.
The party be a laugh. Michelle, please. Fuck it, go.
Good decision.
Fucked up is an understatement.
He's got nice wills, though. For a nutter.
Shut up!
Oh! This place is fucking brilliant.
It's like Wonderland.
This is where the rich kids come to die.
Welcome to my world.
Finally, we're alone.
Not quite.
Oh, Jesus Christ, fuck. I wonder when you were going to turn up.
Hello, Effy.
I'm Jesus Christ.
Anything?
Nothing.
Bollocks.
You know, she may be having a bit of fun. A joke at your expense.
It's not our style. No, I know Effy. She's cleverer than this. In fact, she's the cleverest fucking person I know. Don't know anyone like her. Cass? Look, I'm worried about her. Just, even if we're looking in the same places twice.
Cassie, she was...
Please, Sid. Effy?
Hey, Tone, you've got to come to this party down at Cumberland Basin. We are flying the Virgin Highway.
Who is this?
Effy says hi.
What? Put Effy on the phone! Hello? Fuck! Come on, Sid.
Looks a bit spooky.
You're not still afraid of the dark. You still sleep with that nightlight on, don't you?
It's not a nightlight. It's a glow-in-the-dark Batman. It's retro. Effy! Effy, Effy, Effy! 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 No, I don't think she's here.
No, doesn't look like much of a party, does it?
No. Effy! Effy!
If you want some.
Of course you fucking want some.
There we go. Dr. Stock's marvelous medicine.
Sometimes I think I was born backwards. You know, come out my mum the wrong way. I hear words go past me backwards. The people I should love, I hate. And the people I hate...
Ow! Fuck! All the help I've ever given you, and you've been fucking useless tonight.
I've been good.
You've been useless. You're always fucking useless. Take Michelle. I worked fucking hard to get a shagging opportunity for you, and then you went pussy.
No, I...
Instead, she ends up with this Josh guy, complete fucking knob, who I have to sort. So that's your fault too, you know that?
Sort? What did you do?
Put naked pictures of Abigail on his phone. Made sure Michelle could see him. Made sure everyone could see him. It's quite funny.
Funny? That's sick. His sister, why did you do that?
You know what, Tony? Sometimes I don't know why we're friends anymore.
It's weird, isn't it? I'm from Mars, you're from Venus. I do things, you worry about them. I sleep with girls, you persuade them to attempt suicide.
Then.
you bunching your fists at me, Sid? If you want to hit me, go right ahead. Ow! I said a punch, not a bitch slap. I can't believe you slapped me. It's hilarious. Sid, you better not be crying.
I'm not crying because you punched me.
You're crying for the kids in Africa.
You know I used to so look up to you, don't you?
Of course I did. You're at home every night wanking your brains out. Oh, someday I'll be like Tony. Someday I'll be like Tony.
And now I can think of nothing worse than being you! You've always been selfish.
I always understood that. You did things because you wanted something, fine. Makes sense. But now... now you do things because you can! You fuck with people. And I don't get why. You've got no friends! No girlfriend. Only your parents left. Not even Effy is answering your calls. You're right. She is clever.
Every time you talk, Sid, little flecks of spit are coming out of your mouth and they're going on my face. Sid. Sid, don't be a little girl. Who the fuck is doing this? Yeah. Sid! Sid! How the hell am I gonna get out of here? You're one of them, aren't you?
Hi, this is Cass. Don't bother leaving a message because I'm not listening.
I know you're there, Cassie. I think I know you're there. I want you to be there. I'm at Rockatello's. I want to speak to you. And I think you want to speak to me.
Didn't have to answer, Tony.
I'm grateful that you did.
Okay.
Okay.
So, how come you called me?
I know.
I'll tell you why you rang. It's because you miss me. It's because I'm the only person you can really talk to.
Yeah, Michelle. That's right. This is all about you.
Isn't it?
Not tonight. No.
Are you okay, Tony?
No.
What's the matter?
Effie's missing. So he's supposed to be helping me find her, but he's fucked off. And now I'm at some posh wanker night at the Stonington Sports Club place, and I don't know what to do.
This is the weirdest fucking night of my life.
What do you want me to do, Tony?
I'm running away with you. That's all I am.
ever do. And that's all we ever mean.
You know, it's like 2 in the morning, don't you?
You're the one that's been following me around all night.
Got a black eye growing, did you know that?
Oh, Tony punched me.
Wow, really, that's excellent.
Is it?
We did a course on it at the centre. Separation anxiety. He's worried he's losing you.
Well, I did just leave him. I mean, literally. And then I wanted to see you.
Do you want to kiss me, Sid? Okay, so this is where you lean in. From yesterday's new,
let's leave it all behind. Help me back to my mind. Cool. Sorry, I'm usually better than that.
It's lovely.
No, my rhythm was out and my teeth, they kept getting in the way. Could I try again?
Only if you don't ask. This is for
kind of weirdly, Michelle.
Answer it.
Sid? I'm worried about Tony.
Tony? Just don't worry about him.
I just spoke to him. He sounded strange, in a real mess.
Oh, Michelle, can I ring you back?
He's at some Ston Eaton sports place.
Where?
Ston Eaton.
Listen, I'm in the middle of something important here.
Place where Josh and his mates hang out. Oh, please, Sid, just check he's okay.
Josh.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm leaving now. Tony is in trouble.
Tony. Oh.
I'm really sorry. I've got to go.
Do you?
Kiss me again.
No, Sid. I won't. This is for
some poker, like I'd stud.
I'm looking for my sister.
Oh, she's over there.
Effy! Shit! Effy! Hello? Effy! Effy! What happened? Effy! Effy! What happened? Effy. Someone call an ambulance! Effy. Hello? Yeah. My sister, ambulance. My sister's overdose, I think. Where are we? Where the fuck are we? Wait, where are we? Pass it, I'll give him directions. What the fuck are you doing?
OK, let's make a deal. We'll call an ambulance as soon as you fuck your sister. Three from the top, please, mate.
You're joking?
Well, factually, it's true. So, no. No, not a joke. Or a funny fact.
Get out of my fucking way!
Don't worry, it's not the first time. You won't be taking a virginity, right, Spence?
What, you're fucking insane! She's my sister, you sick fuck!
You put porno pictures of my sister on my phone, and I make you fuck your sister!
Is this about Michelle? You really think Michelle's worth this?
Oh, please, I'm so sorry. I can't get one out.
I can't.
I keep going soft!
Please, please, what have I done? I'm sorry, I promise. I'll get you back with Michelle. I'll do anything, I promise.
Josh, mate. Josh.
Shut the fuck up, Spence.
I want you to fuck her.
No, you can't, mate, no.
Do you want me to play with her a bit?
I can't.
Help you out, yeah?
I really can't.
And then you're a shit brother, aren't you? Oh, yeah.
She's dying over there, Tony!
I promise.
You better get hard!
Beg me.
Well, you only need to ask.
Here endeth the lesson.
Tony? What's happened? What the fuck's happened to her?
It's all my fault.
Okay. It's okay. Let's just get her to a hospital, okay?
See it all tonight underneath the perfect sky. Where the universe revolves around the pupil of an eye. And infinities stretch out from infinities within. I'm a part of everything. I'm a part of everything.
She can hear us.
I don't know, darling.
Effie, love. Her hands are cold.
Well, maybe best let her sleep.
She can hear you, Dad.
It's enough from you. Doctor. Sorry, she.
Oh, it's all looking fine. It's good. Yeah. I guess if I was great. These kids are remarkably resilient creatures, you know. Yeah, it's all gone. And whatever hasn't will be out in a few days, one way or the other. She took some very clean, pure pharmaceuticals. Right, okay. I'll leave you be.
So I suppose we should congratulate you for getting her clean drugs.
You think this was me?
Well, she was with you.
I wasn't. I was.
Oh, don't deny it.
Tony, she's your little sister.
I know. I know. But listen for a second.
No, I've had enough of listening to you. We all have. You and your horrid little ways. Always at other people's expense.
Hang on. That's enough.
What?
He loves Effy. Don't you think this is hard enough?
And who the fuck are you?
I'm his best friend.
And I'm his fucking father.
I know what you are. Come on, Tony. Go in.
I want to stay with Effy.
Come on, mate.
Thank you, Sid.
It's okay. They're free.
No, I mean, really. Thank you.
Yeah, I know what you mean, Tony.
She's gonna be okay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Thing is, I know I can be a wanker sometimes, but everyone likes that, don't they? Ball busting, turning heads wherever I go. People like that. And I like people liking that.
We don't have to do this now.
But then I start to feel distorted because I'm more than that. I don't want to be a wanker. I don't, Sid. So Effy knows that. She loves me for who I really am. God, it's on that fucking Lionel Richie.
I quite like Lionel Richie.
All I know is, when I was scared tonight, I was a bit, a lot. I wanted you there. If he's different, I sort of own her. Because she's my sister, but with you, I just really wanted you there. And then you were in the car.
Thing is, Tony, you sort of own me too. Mostly in a good way. Come on, I'm taking you for breakfast.
You do know it's 4 a.m, don't you?
Yeah, I know. I can find us anywhere that'll do us a curry. Got a real craving for curry.
And close your eyes and don't you make a sound. There's no worry.
Angela!
I'm not mad for fuck's sake! Fine!
Michelle, I need to talk to you.
Tony?
Oh. Will you tell your mum and dad I'm gay?
I never see Maxie, you know?
Oh, he was such a wonderful dancer.
She could get into trouble, couldn't she? Leave him alone.
What the fuck, Angie?
Hello!
You cry.
See that only here on E4 at the same time next week. And if you're after more from the Skins world, including unseen mini-episodes, go to e4.com/skins. Well, coming up, if Ferris Bueller had gone to college, he'd have been suspiciously like Van Wilder. Get a degree in good times in our film next.
And close.